Bogus calls to 911 are posing a real danger to folks who truly need help.
Now, we have heard about this problem before, but it seems to be getting worse. Tonight News' John London explains how the increase in the number of phone calls is putting people at risk who really need help. John?
Yeah, so many calls, Cherie, that aren't true emergencies come in. The system can't handle them all right away. If you're in emergency mode, the last thing you want or need is to be waitlisted.
There are so many 911 calls these days, there are plenty of times when you're left on hold. We're inside the city's communications center. This is where emergency-only calls are supposed to come in, but 911 has become something of a community catch-all number.
It happens all the time, unfortunately, and I think we're probably victims of our own success, maybe, because we put 911 everywhere.
So far this month, there have been nearly 45,000 calls for service in Cincinnati. You could probably categorize almost 17,000 of them as non-emergency.
The system gets backlogged, and then it causes a major problem.
Council's Law Committee Chairman Cecil Thomas says the police non-emergency number needs more visibility.
We probably got to do another education campaign, because, again, 911 seems to be the immediate number that pops in folks' minds.
The problem continues to be studied here and around our cellular-reliant country. How to get all of us to reserve 911 for true emergencies and call 765-1212 for anything else. A solution that seems easier said than dialed.
I don't know that there is a fix for it because, as you know, the cell phone is ubiquitous. Everybody has a cell phone today, and people want to do the right thing.
Estes says he and the 911 dispatchers who work diligently under great strain and pressure appreciate the intent, but would prefer you plug that 765-1212 number into your phone for calls that are not life-threatening. Cherie?